The new administration has promised to uphold the constitution of the country in both word and deed as it governs the nation over the next 5 years. That began with the appointment of a deputy speaker after 5 years without one. The new administration has also vowed to stamp out corruption.
My government, in recognition of the widespread, unprecedented reports of alleged corruption during the term of the last administration, will appoint a special prosecutor to investigate allegations of corruption in government. This appointment is expected to be completed soon. My government will strengthen the Integrity Commission to return our country to a system that respects our democratic norms and the rights of the people. My government will reactivate the bipartisan parliamentary committee to review Justice Susie Doven's constitution report and the parliamentary recommendations with a view to adopting final recommendations for implementation.
This administration has given the assurance that it will not interfere in the affairs of the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, promising to provide the force with the necessary tools to fight crime.
You will have noticed that in my Prime Minister's configuration of ministries, the absence of a Minister for National Security. Given the highly important role of the police, the Prime Minister's office will be the oversight authority for policing. My government's intention is to provide greater operational independence to our police service and the police and the Commissioner of Police. The police should be allowed to do their work without being encumbered by political decisions of politicians.
The new administration will soon provide relief to those unemployed as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic. Businesses, too, will receive support.
My government remains concerned about the many businesses affected by the COVID-19 pandemic and will establish a business recovery unit within the Ministry of Commerce to lend support through a series of fiscal and non-fiscal measures to those businesses in the process of recovery.
Completing the St. Jude Hospital within the shortest possible time will be the top priority for the government, as it also aims to get the COVID-19 crisis under control. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.